The topic which we are going to see in this video is electric field due to uniformly charged thin spherical shell. This is the last application of Gauss's theorem in our syllabus, and this is also the last topic of the chapter as well. Electric field due to uniformly charged thin spherical shell. For this, to find electric field, we need to consider a spherical shell of radius capital R having a charge Q. I would like to tell you one property of this shell, that all the charge on the shell resides on its surface. Any excess charge given to the shell resides on the surface of the shell. There is no charge inside the spherical shell. We need to find electric field at distance R. We need to find electric field at distance small r. Now this distance small r could be any distance. It could be either inside the spherical shell, it could be either on the surface of the spherical shell, or it could be either outside the spherical shell. So there will be three cases which we are going to see in this derivation is: one, electric field inside the spherical shell; two, electric field outside the spherical shell; and three, electric field on the surface of the spherical shell. For calculating the electric field at distance r, we would consider a Gaussian surface of the same distance, of the same radius r. So first case which we are going to take is when r is greater than capital R, that is we are going to find electric field outside the spherical shell. To find electric field outside the shell, we are going to consider a Gaussian surface of radius small r such that small r is greater than capital R. Now again, by Gauss's theorem, E dot ds is equal to Q enclosed divided by epsilon naught. So here, this is a positive charge. Its electric field would be directed radially outwards. Its area vector would be directed radially outwards. Both electric field and area vector are directed radially outwards. So the angle between the two is 0 degree. So here it would be E ds cos 0. And Q enclosed, what is the charge enclosed by the total Gaussian surface? It is capital Q. So it would be capital Q divided by epsilon naught. Taking symmetry into consideration, E d, E will come outside the integration, ds the integral would be equal to Q divided by epsilon naught. So E into the, this is a small ds of the complete spherical Gaussian surface. So the total surface area of the Gaussian surface is 4 pi r square, which is equal to Q divided by epsilon naught, which could be written as E is equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught r square. 4 pi and r square will come in denominator. Now we could write 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught as Kc. So E would be Kc capital Q by R square, which implies electric field is inversely proportional to R square. And also we can conclude from here that the complete shell is acting as if it is a point charge, and its whole charge is concentrated at the center, because electric field due to point charge is also given by Kcq by R square. This is the first case. Second case, if we are going to see, is R is equal to capital R. The only change which is going to come is, this is the case where we are studying on the surface, electric field on the surface of the shell. The only change which is going to come in the formula is E would be equal to Kc capital Q by capital R square. This is the only change in case 2. Please note it down. Next case which we are going to see is case 3, that is R is less than capital R. That is, we are talking about the electric field inside the shell now. If we need to find electric field inside the shell, then the Gaussian surface would be having the radius small r now, such that small r is less than capital R. Blue will be the Gaussian surface. Now, we have already seen one property, that charge enclosed within the Gaussian surface is zero. Charge inside the shell is zero. So, charge enclosed within the Gaussian surface would be zero. So, by Gauss's law, E dot ds would be equal to Q enclosed divided by epsilon naught. But here, Q enclosed is zero. So, E dot ds would be equal to zero, which implies E is equal to 0. E is equal to 0. If we plot the graph of E versus R, we would see electric field is 0 till R is less than capital R. Then it would suddenly increase and it would become Kc capital Q by R square. This is the point at which R is equal to capital R. And when R becomes greater than capital R, electric field is inversely proportional to R square. Electric field is inversely proportional to R square. So it will follow a hyperbolic graph. This is all about electric field due to uniformly charged thin spherical shell. And this also completes chapter 1. Thank you, everyone.